Shalom, everybody, and how are you? I want to speak something concerning my nation, Kenya, this morning. And I want to pass forth a word concerning my nation today. Now, the nation of Kenya is at the verge of high revival. And just like in the book of Matthew chapter 2, Herod was still alive. In the birth of Jesus Christ, Herod was still alive. You remember in Matthew chapter 2, when the wise men were prompted by the Lord to go where Jesus was born, and they were read by the star. And they passed by where Herod was, you know. And we see Herod is gathering the chief priests and the scribes of the people together and to inquire where this Christ was born. And, you know, he also called the wise men to confide to them and to make some personal inquiry, being the king. And the Bible is saying when these wise men were departing, Herod made a request that go and see, do your personal search, go and see, and after you have seen, come back and tell me so that I could also go and worship him. Now, my people in the nation of Kenya, more so the church of this country, something has been happening in this country, and we cannot pray a bright eye. There is a demonic cartel. I call it a demonic cartel that is covering up in the church of Jesus Christ. Some of these people are deep in the demonic, very deep in the demonic. And these are like operating in the spirit of Herod. They can see it, they know it, and they know it is time for the revival of this country. And with their titles and with their influence, they want to hijack. Because whatever kind of worship Herod is talking about, it was not a real worship. Actually, because Jesus was born as a king of kings, Herod could not admit or agree that another king has been born who is higher than me. So he really wanted just to know where this baby is, to destroy his destiny. Hallelujah. But I want to encourage the church in the nation of Kenya, no matter what. The Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4, that whatever is born of God overcomes the world. The revival of the nation of Kenya will not be sabotaged by any demonic agent posing with whichever title, in the church of this country. Now, there are people moving around and trying to organize here and there, blah, blah, do things. But if you test, that's why the Bible, church, the Bible has commanded us to test every spirit. Testing every spirit does not mean you are judging anybody. Not judging anybody. They'll call you for prayers, they'll call you for food, they'll call you for what? You know, particularly the men of God, the new priesthood, be on your guard, be on your guard. The spirit of Herod is in operation in the nation of Kenya, and it is out to mess up even what you are seeing them do. You see Herod is coming up like with a good intention. And I love what the Bible says, that in verse 2 of Matthew chapter 2, the Bible says, these wise men were divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod. They departed for their own country another way. I'm requesting the new priesthood in the nation of Kenya. Kenya is in a verge. We are in that moment of the long-awaited revival. The other thing is that the nation of Kenya is in her season of being positioned in the nations of the world. That's why you see, because of this loophole that is there coming from the church, the counterfeit, and the spirit that is trying to sabotage, which will not manage. I stand as an authority, as a prophetic voice of God in the nation of Kenya. I stand as an authority this morning to declare and to let everybody know. I know there are people who are genuinely serving God and genuinely praying for the destiny of this country. The prophetic destiny of the nation of Kenya will not be sabotaged by anybody. The fake apostles, you know, covering up in prayer movements and what have you. The fake prophets, any counterfeit, whether a pastor, a teacher, or an evangelist, nobody, whichever title they are calling themselves, they will not be able to sabotage like God, the way he wants this wise man. There is a warning to the true servants of God in this country. Not every luncheon is your luncheon. Whether they are giving whatever the drinks or the venue is free, not everything is for you. Avoid sabotage. Actually, the devil is working around the clock to sabotage the true graces of God in the nation of Kenya. So be on your lookout. Be on your lookout. I'm speaking to men and women of God in county levels. Be very careful. Don't allow the agents of the devil to gather you, covering up in the church. Test every spirit. Be very careful. Don't eat with them. Don't attend their meetings. Say no to any man of ungodliness. You can discern anybody in the spirit of God. You can discern that which is of God. It's not about the title. Herod was very senior. He was a king, you know, and he was surrounded by the chief priests, by the scribes. He could reach them out, but his intention towards Jesus, the birth of Jesus, it was not true worship. He wanted to sabotage and to cut off that king that was born that moment in the name of Jesus. So we are in that season right now, and any seed the devil is trying to bring in the destiny of this country, even from other nations, is because the nation of Kenya is in that a moment of being positioned, rightfully positioned in the nations of the world. So I want to encourage even the government of the nation of Kenya, not everything that comes from whichever nation, and it does not matter, that belongs to this country. We reject any foreign seed. We say no as a church of this country. We say no to any seed that is not of God. And I want to assure people, thank you, Holy Spirit. I feel so heavy in my spiritual hope. No demon, no spirit of hell, no nation, no government from whichever nation, no authorities in this world will be able to sabotage the process of God for this country and mess up with the prophetic destiny of the nation of Kenya in the name of Jesus. So, men of God, let us hearken to the voice of God. Let us know who is who and what is who. That does not mean you are judging. The Bible says, test every spirit. Be on your lookout. Be very careful. I don't fear saying these things. Some people began in the spirit, but they have gone, because of status quo, they have gone for foreign gods. They are using marine spirits. They are using powers of witchcraft. They have gone to demonic altars to consult Okatsim. You know, they are using demonic rings, demonic chains, demonic crosses. I'm not saying every cross is demonic, but there are some of these, even Bibles, have been taken to some demonic altars to be treated. We know these things. I'm told even some people are now swallowing the rings, you know, from demonic altars. Others have gone to demonic altars to be locked up with the pagans, you know, for some days, to be locked up in a to be cooked with the pots in some demonic altars. We know these things, and you know them, because these things are not strange. We know the word of God from the book of Ezekiel. These things are there, and the demonic operation has always been there all the days. So let us be careful, and let us know that Jesus is coming back. Even as we prepare for this as a nation of Kenya, let us know Jesus is coming back. Follow up the activities that are going on in the nation of Israel. As a nation, we are for Israel. We are for the peace of Jerusalem, for the sake of our prosperity, as we are for the nation of Israel, because it is commanded of the word of God. So be on the lookout. There is a lot of partying in the church, a lot of eating, a lot of partying. And these are traps of the enemy. These are traps of the enemy to sabotage and to covenant even the people who are elect, if possible. Be very, very careful. Be very, I don't say eating together, fellowshipping on a cup of tea or whatever people gather for. I don't say it is bad, but I'm saying test every spirit. Know the spirit behind 1, 2, 3 things. I've just sent some messages to some servants of God in this country this morning. The Lord woke me up and told me, you know, gave me a name of somebody in this country and told me, oh my goodness, it has been so painful in my spirit. So and so is going to be killed by so and so. You know, you hear some of these things in the spirit. And this person, oh my goodness, you feel, you know, because if you're not very careful, you eat with the people who want to kill you spiritually, kill you. They can even kill you physically. They can kill your ministry. You know, when they cut you off in the spiritual realm, they finish you up. And this person is, you know, is so submitted to the person I've had in the spirit, you know, because these are spiritual operations. If somebody is able to kill you spiritually, then they have finished you even physically, because your destiny will never become a reality in the name of Jesus Christ. So let us pray for each other. Why I sent that message I had in the spirit is because I want us to pray for each other. Let us pray for each other. The church was left praying when Herod captured Peter and locked him up in cells. The church was left interceding. Let us pray for each other. A kingdom that is not standing together can never, you know, can never start. A kingdom that is divided will never start. We don't have two heavens. We don't have two Jesus. We only have one Jesus. We are coming from one spirit. We are coming from one God, and we are going to one heaven, and we have one Savior, and we are all of us are members of his body in the name of Jesus. So let us know we are in that moment of our revival. Let us be very careful. That's why you see some meetings are being done even nationally. I know government meetings, they are targeted to mess up and to sabotage, you know, the seed of God in this country. But we have the power and authority over every unclean spirit, and we are taking charge of our nation in the name of Jesus Christ. So let us be on our lookout, and let us know that the Lord has come to do what he promised to do in the nation of Kenya. And I want to promise you that it's going to be to happen very fast in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Shalom.